Playing Division I sports on the college level is very demanding for all student athletes. Many hours spent on the court, on the rink, or on the field, and in some select cases, in other countries. Traveling abroad is a great experience that can go well beyond the direct competition felt during the game. Experiencing different cultures and exploring different countries is a tremendous way to expand the overall student experience. Travel with us for these stories and more coming up next on Quinnipiac University Bobcats Unleashed. Bobcats Unleashed. I'm Jenny Parker.
And I'm Billy Mecca.
Today we're going to talk with a Quinnipiac University student athlete who found his way onto the lacrosse field on somewhat of an unusual yet remarkable path. And we'll also take a look at the role of community service and what it means to them.
But first, we'll take a look at the trips our women's basketball and field hockey teams took to Europe these past two summers, and we'll discover the value in teams making their way across the pond.
When any time you have the opportunity to travel with your team, it's really a great bonding experience.
Where you get to see each other in a different light, traveling together, and also meet different people.
We made a conscious effort to intermingle and to get to know everybody, which was really great. So that helped on the field, because the closer you are off the field, the better you're going to perform on the field.
We got to room with different girls at each place, so we got to bond with someone new.
And it was just a great experience because we all got to just work together, and you know, now we're starting this season and we're tighter than ever.
They did bond. We all did bond in different ways, and you didn't even know it was happening in the 10 days. Again, until you came back, you see how special that really was, and I think that's going to grow in their future as well as in mine.
The bonding that takes place is incredible, but to experience Europe firsthand is breathtaking.
The opportunity for many of our teams to take summer trips to Europe is just something that is very, very special at Quinnipiac, and it particularly gives our student athletes the opportunity to see and feel things they just don't know existed.
I've never been overseas before, so this was definitely experience of a lifetime, so I was so excited to hear that we were going.
Words can't describe when you touch down in Rome what's really going to be ahead of you.
My favorite moment was definitely when we arrived first in Venice, and riding on the boat, just seeing the city, like the entire city's on water.
It was so awesome. It was just like you saw in the movies. There was canals everywhere, the buildings were beautiful, and it was just amazing.
All of a sudden, a monkey like jumped on my head. I don't know if it was because my hair was braided or I was blonde. Something attracted it to me, but.
My favorite moment was going to Mass at St. Peter's Basilica.
When we were in like Venice and Florence, we would just like walk up to random people and start, it was just so cool to see like where all these different walks of life were coming from, and you know, we were actually there to experience that. So I loved, that was one of my favorite parts.
While the sights of Europe certainly inspire the student athletes, they also appreciate the chance to visit some very special kids.
We had the opportunity to go to an orphanage in Portugal, and these are children that have no parents, obviously, who spend 24/7 at this orphanage, and we had the opportunity to go and teach them some field hockey.
I mean, you just see these kids, and we show up with sticks and balls and all these prizes, and all they wanted to do was play field hockey, and they loved passing.
For them to be so excited to see us and wanting to know everything about us, wanting to know about our culture, our sport, was really a humbling experience.
So I think that moment for us was almost your giving back for this generous gift that Quinnipiac gave us the opportunity to have.
The opportunity to travel abroad is a great experience for all students and a priority for the university.
Oh, it's important for all of our students. I mean, we push study abroad programs and international experiences, and particularly for our winter sports. Our student athletes, because of their schedule, they play in the winter and spring semester, and they really can't take advantage of the study abroad opportunities.
They do leave here and they're incredibly grateful. They turn back and say, that was the most amazing experience of my life. And now that I'm in the real world and I'm a doctor or I'm a PT or I'm an OT, they walk around and they realize how rare that experience was.
So our student athletes are very, very fortunate to not only experience a great education at Quinnipiac, but to experience life as a young student, life as an adult in places all over the world.
I could never have this experience again. So having it and being able to remember it and taking the pictures and being with my team and collectively just being together, it was something I will never forget.
There's no words. I mean, all I can say is thank you. It was honestly the trip of a lifetime, something I'll be able to tell my kids and my grandkids, you know. I mean, this is just, it was a blessing. I will never forget it.
Man, I wish I was on that trip. Great food and amazing views.
I tell you what, the teams had a great time, and they created memories that will last forever.
All right, coming up next on Quinnipiac University Bobcats Unleashed, we'll catch up with Blake Gaddison and find out about his extraordinary road that he took to get to the lacrosse team. Stay with us. Welcome back to Quinnipiac University Bobcats Unleashed. I'm Jamie Parker.
And I'm Billy Mecca. You know, Jamie, recruiting just might be the single most important ingredient for the success of an athletic program. And a college visit from those prospects is a crucial component in the recruiting process.
Yeah, I had a chance to catch up with a few basketball coaches and talk about planning that visit with a potential student athlete.
So, Coach, I want to talk to you about when you have a potential student athlete coming in here for an official visit and about the sense of community that you want to show to him and make him feel comfortable here.
Well, when we bring people up, the first thing is just getting them on this campus, and we always talk about just come up and see it. You'll fall in love with the place, and it's just amazing. So they get that feel, and you know, we always sell to them, hey, listen, you're going to be, you know, a member of our team, which has 13 scholarship players. You're going to be a member of the athletic department, which has 400, and then you're going to be a member of our a whole school community, which has 7,200 undergrads. So we say you're going to have a nice family when you're done here, and that's what I try and do and make the parents feel like when they drop their kids off with us, they're going to be taken care of for 4 years, and we're going to make sure they graduate. We're going to make sure they become good, continue to become good citizens, and you know, make them grow as people.
And we have three values that guide everything we do: high quality academic programs, student oriented environment, and a strong sense of community here. So, students are our customers. They're the most important reason we're here.
You know, we want the kid to have a great experience. We want them obviously to graduate, and we tell them they're going to graduate. There's not an issue if they're not going to graduate or not. They're going to graduate. We want them to win a lot of games and have a successful basketball career. And we want them to grow. We want good representatives of Quinnipiac, but more importantly, even good representatives of Quinnipiac basketball.
As a former athlete, a former NBA player, and obviously champion as well with the beautiful ring that we have here. does that come into play at all when you're meeting some of these recruits that you can kind of relate to them?
It does. One thing I do, I like to wear my ring a lot of times when I go recruiting, because it's hard for kids. Kids don't really talk as much as they used to. Mm-hmm. You know, they're used to texting, used to emails, all that stuff. So they don't communicate as much. So when I do wear my ring, they see it. They'll say, "What is that from?" And I say, "You know, playing for an NBA championship with the Bulls and playing with Michael Jordan." They open up. They talk to you more. It's easier to get connect with the kid. And the coaches usually know who I am, but the kid doesn't. So the coach always helps me out. The high school coach helps me out and makes everything a lot easier.
As you get to know a kid, you're talking to his parents, you're talking to his coach, you hear what people around him are saying about the kid. And then once you meet him on visits, whether it's unofficials or officials, and you see him interact with the guys on the team, a lot of times it'll hit either myself or one of my assistants will say, "Boy, I hope we get him because he'd fit perfectly here."
What kind of emphasis do you put on academics with the players that come here?
Well, I mean, it's the number one piece with the kids we recruit. When you leave here after 4 years of playing basketball, you've got to be prepared for the rest of your life.
Do you stress that with the parents as well, that you guys are really focused on academics?
Absolutely. We've been fortunate that all of the kids that we've had come through the program and remain here have graduated. Mm-hmm. We have a very high APR, which is how the NCAA measures the academic progress of your program, and our guys are successful.
Yeah, you talk about Alyssa and what she does. How critical has she been for your program? Because she's your personal, mm-hmm. just for the men's basketball team.
Well, she's way more important than I am. I know that. Yep, absolutely. Alyssa has been unbelievable. She is on top of our guys 24/7. She knows what they're doing better than they do.
It's a really unique situation because there are not a lot of schools at this level that have one person dedicated just to men's basketball.
And she finds a way to get through to each and every one of them, and they've achieved. I mean, our team GPA is always up around a 3.0, which is way above the national average, and we're real proud of that.
I've been to every graduation, and we've seen our players graduate, we've seen our managers graduate, and it's a proud day.
And it's fun to sit there and watch. I like to watch the parents. To see a parent smile when they see their son walk across the stage and get that degree is unbelievable.
It's interesting to see how academics, athletic facilities, and campus life blend into playing such a vital role in the recruiting process.
Yeah, you're right, Billy. It really comes down to that perfect fit between the university and the student athlete. All right, now let's get caught up with Bill Schweitzer in our latest edition of Bobcat Bits.
Thanks, Jamie. Well, what an exciting time at Quinnipiac. Championships, the order of the day. Women's cross country race to its eighth straight Northeast Conference title. That's the longest streak in any NEC-sponsored sport. Senior Becca White ran her best time of the season to lead the Bobcats to the win. Then soccer won their first ever NEC championship, and to the victors go the spoils. Eric DaCosta was named the conference coach of the year. Bobcats leading scorer Philip Surprise was named the first team all-conference, and teammates William Daniels and Robbie McClarney were second team all-NEC. On November 10th, eight individual athletes, two coaches, two teams were inducted into the Quinnipiac Athletic Hall of Fame. Men's hockey coach Rand Pecknold and his championship team of 2002, as well as the field hockey coach Becca Main and her 2001 championship team, were among those inducted. The Bobcats women's rugby team completed a perfect 11-0 season, beating Albany 22-14 to win the Tri-State Conference Championship. Head coach Becky Carlson's team outscored the opposition, get ready for this, 605-42. Quinnipiac's TD Bank Sports Center has been selected as the site of the 2014 NCAA Women's Ice Hockey Frozen Four. Athletic Director Jack McDonald said, "We feel very confident that our facility, our staff, and our fans will show the NCAA Women's Ice Hockey student athletes and their fans a first-class championship experience." The Bobcats women's basketball team has been picked as the preseason favorite to win the Northeast Conference Championship, and Coach Trish Fabry's team has gotten off to a strong start, winning their first six games, including the championship of the Brown Bear Invitational in Providence, with convincing wins over New Hampshire and Rider. The Bobcats men's hockey team has its sights set high in the ECAC. The Bobcats haven't lost since early November, and they're off to a 6-0 start in the conference. Exciting times at Quinnipiac University. Billy, Jamie, back to you.
Thanks, Bill. When we return, we will visit with some student athletes who have been very busy in the local community. We'll be right back.
Hello, and welcome back to Quinnipiac University, Bobcats Unleashed. You know, in addition to sports and studies, community service is paramount to a lot of teams, and Bill Schweitzer caught up with a few teams who've been spending a lot of time helping others.
Thanks, Jamie and Billy. You know, Quinnipiac athletes spend a lot of time on the court, on the ice, on the fields, but they also spend a lot of time helping others in the community as role models. Now, I got a chance to talk to some of the student athletes and the coaches about why this is so important.
Here we go.
Two, three.
For our student athletes to have an opportunity to give back to the community and to realize how fortunate that some of them are by seeing maybe some people that are less fortunate and being able to make a difference in their life, I think that's a pretty powerful life lesson for them to be able to learn.
Seeing the faces of the little kids is amazing. It's a great experience.
When you give, it definitely makes you feel better because you get just the same amount in return.
I was very excited to see them coming here because it's not happened to me. Well, basketball, the parents come to my school.
They can take time out of their life to come to us and spend like a little bit of time with us. So I found that very rewarding.
So I couldn't be proud of our student athletes, particularly our coaches, for spearheading the way, for making our student athletes feel and realize how important they are in the lives of other people.
Helping others is a privilege for these student athletes, and being a role model is one benefit of that opportunity.
I think what it does for our players is it really sort of reinforces to them that there are a lot of other people out there in the community that look up to them and that see them as a positive role model.
I remember growing up that I would have loved to have a Division I athlete come and show support and give me encouragement to keep going and keep studying hard so one day we could go to college.
These men are symbols of what we hope our kids grow up to be. They're more than just athletes, they're students, and they're students in college who worked really hard.
And like they have to get good grades in order to keep on playing. And it's like, it's very hard, but they enjoy it too.
So when they see kids who look like them and come from communities like theirs, who are in college and, you know, here to send the message about what it took to get there, it's a big deal. It's an important day.
When I saw them, I thought they were extremely tall and they looked like they were very good at playing basketball.
Well, every day since then, they've been asking me, are the big kids coming to play? So it was really cool to see how they really looked up to them.
To be able to see the reactions of the younger kids and see them literally look up, you know, and figuratively look up to our kids and think, I want to go to college, I want to be a student athlete, I want to do this down the road. And to know that maybe that connection that they made with an individual child that day makes a difference in that kid's life, I think it's really neat.
It's a big honor to be in that position, to have children look up to you, and I think it kind of reminds us that we are so fortunate to have an opportunity like this.
And what an opportunity it is, helping others, having fun, and simply feeling good at the end of the day.
I think it's great. It's great for our program. We always come away, the kids always come away feeling a little energized by our community service events, and I think the people, when we leave whatever event we're doing, I think they feel very good about us coming to see them too as well.
The team explained to them that they were getting all this equipment and that they were getting pennies, and as soon as they started handing out the pennies, kids were jumping, screaming. I had tears in my eyes. It was so great.
I can't tell you, in my 18 years as athletic directors, attending one of those community service with our student athletes, it's the only time in athletics where everybody wins and nobody loses.
I'm privileged to be a student athlete, and I have to give back, and it's a great feeling that I was able to do something like that.
You know, it's nothing like the intense pressure when game time rolls around. These student athletes really enjoy the fulfillment of helping others.
Thanks, Bill. It's pretty special to see the kids getting involved in the local community.
It is all about giving back. And that's going to do it for this edition of Quinnipiac University Bobcats Unleashed. For Billy Mecca, Bill Schweitzer, and our entire Unleashed team, I'm Jamie Parker, and thanks for watching.